Hey growers, thanks for tuning in. My name's Steven and I'm part of the Grobo team. I'm excited today because we're gonna do a new feature in the app. It's our calibration feature. We're gonna be calibrating our pH probe and I'm gonna show you the difference between what the pH probe and the EC probe is, why we need them, and what they do. Let's dig into the box. Let's start with the EC probe. This probe is stored and shipped dry, but it does come with a protective container that you can simply remove. You'll notice that this probe has a glass loop on the end of it, and on either side of the glass loop are two silver pads. Once these pads are connected by water, we can measure the EC of your Grobo. More importantly, the electrical conductivity of the salt in your Grobo's food. It is important to keep this probe clear of debris and clean, but know that you don't need to calibrate it, as it is calibrated at the factory. The second probe in your Grobo is the pH probe. It also comes in a protective chamber, but this one has a storage solution in it. It's important that you keep your probe wet at all times. This one has a glass ball at the end of it. It looks like it's surrounded by a castle wall or pieces of plastic that look like crenulations. With this probe, we're going to be measuring the potential of hydrogen in your system.
We begin in the app on my unit, the Grobo Premium number 1. I'm growing Gorilla Glue number 4, which is a hybrid here. I've already cleaned this unit since my last grow. The reservoir is nice and clean, and now I can check the health of my pH probe. Under the maintenance tab, you're going to find calibrate button. The unit will check that you're online briefly, and here we go. Now we're going to be able to check the health of our probe. What we're going to do first is clean it and then check the health. So let's click next. The tools you need are a glass filled with tap water, two empty glasses that can be plastic or glass. You're going to need a 7.0 calibration solution satchel and a 4.0 calibration solution satchel. All of those are available in the kit. So once you have all those things ready, you're good to go, but do make sure you have about 10 minutes because this does take a couple minutes each time you calibrate. Once you have all the tools gathered, you're ready. For our first step, we're going to be cleaning the tip of the probe. I recommend following the Blue Labs cleaning instructions. Let's see how I clean the tip of a probe with the kit.
Let's check out how to keep these pH probes clean. We use Blue Labs, they're out of New Zealand, and they're the pros in the pH business. We know that calibration is important, but cleaning is just as important. If my plant is showing signs of stress, first place I look is my pH probe and make sure it's clean. If it is, then I calibrate it. That'll knock out most of the problems you're gonna have with the Grobo and any deficiencies. Let's dive into this kit and see what it's doing, how it's helping us keep it clean and calibrated.
See if it's healthy. Place your probe in a plastic cup from the kit and pour an entire 7.0 calibration solution satchel into the cup. Ensure that the probe tip is covered and watch out for tipping. It's pretty top heavy. Now that you've done that, let's check to see if the probe is healthy. Now this process does take 2 minutes, so be patient. I'll pause here so you don't have to wait the full 2 minutes. As we finish checking up the probe health, we have two possible results. One, your probe is healthy and calibration will be complete. Or, two, your probe needs to be calibrated, and in that case, calibration will begin. Let's see what happens in this case. A calibration is recommended. Let's calibrate. We have not moved the probe out of the 7.0 solution, so we can hit calibrate right now. 2 more minutes to calibrate your 7.0 reference point. Sweet, we're halfway there. Let's pause the video. Great, our 7.0 has been calibrated. We're done the step, we're halfway there. Now it's time to swap out liquids. Get a fresh shot glass or plastic cup that comes in the kit and fill it with your 4.0 calibration solution. Rinse the pH probe off in some tap water, then into the 4.0 calibration solution. Once the probe is steady, let's hit calibrate again. And once again, it's going to take us 2 minutes to calibrate this reference point. Let's pause the video. This is our last calibration point, so we calibrated to 7.0 and we calibrate to 4.0, so the probe has the most accuracy between those reference values. Most of our recipes, for example, run between 5.5 and 6.5 pH. So as we finish this 2 minutes, we complete the calibration process, and you can see it's been a success. So we're all calibrated. Your probe is clean, it's calibrated, it's ready to go for your next grow. You can return the probe to the Grobo. Good luck, growers.
Thanks for joining us, growers. I appreciate you watching this video. I had fun making it. This was how to calibrate your probe. Remember, the calibration checks the health of your probe, and if it's healthy, you don't need to calibrate. If it's not, it will calibrate for you. How often should you do this health check? I do it at bare minimum every grow, but remember, the more often you calibrate, the better and more accurate your probe is, the more plant you'll have. See you next time.